She's a victim of a medical condition. I'm very aware that there are other victims out there because of her crime. She's aware of it. That's not what this is about. This is purely about the law states that if something is medically necessary, that they get the treatment.
Medically necessary. A federal judge in Massachusetts ruled that a man serving a life sentence for killing his wife is, because he's transgender, entitled to a sex change operation paid for by taxpayers. Joining me is attorney and legal affairs commentator Areva Martin and author Pamela Geller. Now, you guys have different opinions on this. Pamela Geller, what do you think? Does this open the door to more procedures?
This is an outrageous judicial abuse of taxpayer dollars. Cheryl Kosilek was nearly decapitated by her husband. She met him in a rehab center. She thought she could help him. With a wire, he nearly decapitated her. He was convicted to life without parole. The very idea that we'd be paying for a sex chain operation is outrageous. First of all, it has not been determined that it's medically necessary. And by the way, it is not. You cannot equate it with cancer treatments or heart surgery. He's serving a life sentence. He's a convicted murderer. The man sat down to a steak dinner after he did away with her body. What are we talking about here? Once you're convicted of murder, you forego certain rights.
I let you speak.
We're talking ahead, 40 Pam. To 80,000. Thank you, dear. $40,000 to $80,000. $40,000 to $80,000. When this country's $16 trillion in debt, it's irresponsible. It shows an utter lack of contempt for the American people and for taxpayer dollars.
We're going to stay with within the bounds of the taxpayer dollars and the prison. Pam, back to you. Are you concerned that a convicted felon with male genitalia is going to be in a female prison?
I'm concerned that this sets a dangerous precedent. The family of the decapitated woman, Cheryl Kosilek, is imploring the judge to reconsider, is looking for an appeal. You can go to my site, atlasshrugs.com. I'll provide a link to the petition. I urge all Americans to speak out against this. We're getting distracted here. The bottom line is it's a convicted murderer serving a life sentence without parole. Why would the taxpayer be spending upwards of $50,000 to $80,000 for a sex change?
Let's throw a call into this mix.
A social life in prison, it's ridiculous.
Sandra.
Height of insanity.
Sandra in Arkansas. Sandra, you want to throw something into the mix here?
Yes, I'd like to be in the mix.
Go ahead.
First of all, Dr. Drew, thank you for having me, and I'm very, very appalled at this. I think, first of all, the judge should be removed. This is ridiculous. I mean, there are other inmates with other life-threatening problems that should be considered. It's as if this person is getting his dream. He's always wanted to be a woman. And so he killed his wife, go to prison for 20 years, and what happens? He get a chance to get a sex change, something he have always wanted. It's just not fair. It's not fair to the families of the murdered woman. It's just not fair.
Okay, Sandra, I'm gonna hold it right there. I feel like I've gotta quickly take a break because you just threw a little lighter fluid on my panel here. And I'm sure they're each gonna have something to say in response to what you have to say. So that and more of your calls after the break. We are talking about a convicted felon who is transgender getting taxpayers to pay for a sex change operation. Areva Martin was going to comment to our last caller, Sandra, who was outraged that the judge thought the judge should be removed. And Sandra, of course, Areva, of course, is still bristling at having been called sweetie by Pam. So we'll start there.
Okay. It's such a difficult topic, Dr. Drew. And Sandra, I agree with you. I hate murderers. And I particularly hate murderers who kill their wives. I'm a wife. So, you know, I don't have any compassion for this man that killed his wife. But we have to separate the murder, the punishment from the murder, from what he is entitled to when he is in prison, if he has a medical condition. So if there is a true need, and we've heard that this guy tried to commit suicide twice, he tried to castrate himself, he's had all kinds of psychological issues associated with being a transgender person, that the judge decided that the medical evidence supported the surgery.
How would you convince somebody like Pam? Pam said, well, this is an outrage. Pam said this guy's getting his dream. He's going to have a social life. He's going
to
be a woman.
Pam, Pam, you have to separate the issues here. I'm not advocating for this guy getting anything in prison that he's not entitled to. But the Eighth Amendment says you cannot be treated cruelly. Cruel and unusual punishment does not exist in our judicial system. And if there is a finding of medical evidence that supports the need for surgery, it could be hip surgery, back surgery, any kind of surgery, then he has to get it. I don't care if he becomes a woman or a man or what, but if he needs the surgery, the taxpayers have to pay for it. We will pay for the treatment, the hormone treatment, the psychological treatment. That's all taxpayers' dollars. We're paying for him to be housed in this jail. So
Pam,
this is no different.
Go right ahead.
Kudos to the caller, because at the end of the day, with all the talking heads there are, the American people are very rational. What happens next? People going to prison so that they can get a sex change operation? There is, it has not been deemed medically necessary. This is not on par with cancer treatment. This is not on, this is not life threatening. And may I add, Cheryl Kosilek doesn't get to wake up in the morning and decide whether she enjoys being a woman or enjoys being a man or to ponder these issues. She was slaughtered in cold blood. He's a convicted murderer. He does not get a sex change operation. This is not rocket science. There's no ambiguity here. This is not a tough case. There is nothing to separate. He's serving a life sentence. He's a murderer. He doesn't get a sex.
Throw another call in here, Mom, about this.
I just want to talk about stepping back, Dr. Drew, and we can't seem to separate the fact that we're talking about a convicted murderer.
And by the way, it's convicted murderer on one hand, who we don't really feel great about getting health care. And it seems like an elective thing. It's provocative.
And I just want to say the court had to consider all of that. The court had to consider the medical evidence, a high standard of proof. I'm not concerned that this is going to set some kind of precedent that everyone that wants a sex change is going to be able to run into court and get one.
What about a hip operation? What about
elective surgery? It takes a lot of evidence, a lot of proof to be able to get any kind of serious medical treatment in prison. So I don't think the American, you know, public has to worry that we're going to start spending our money, you know, frivolously on these prisoners that don't need the surgeries. There had to be a clear showing of need in this case before this judge would have ruled that this man is entitled to the surgery. I feel pretty confident about that.
But Pam, you disagree.
Well, how do you quantify need? Why is one's need more important than another one's need? I mean, you're getting into this crazy leftist area. I don't know how you're going to sort it out. It's wrong. It's wrong on all fronts. It's wrong. The issues that transgenders have are absolutely understandable. This is not the case. This is a convicted murderer. They treat these cases with hormones, with psychological counseling. But the idea that you're going to give a $50,000 to $80,000 sex change operation based on what? Again, it's not life and death. There's no abuse here. And if it was so, you know, necessary, how did he get married? You know, how did he marry his wife and then, of course, slaughter her? I'm sorry. There is absolutely no gray area here. I don't understand how you're even making this argument. Separating the murderer from this case, you can't. You can't. It's what it is. It's what it is. There's no separating it out. And the taxpayer funds should not be used for a sex change operation.
And Pam, we will have to leave it there. I want to thank you, Pam Geller, Ariva Martin. Thank you for joining me throughout the show. And, of course, Nina Arsenault. Nina, again, we really appreciate you coming here, giving that opinion.